Hi everyone, this is Qiuchen from Nanjing Medical University. Today, I'm excited to share with you our article published in JEM titled Transport of Beta-Amyloid from Brain to Eye Causes Retinal Degeneration in Alzheimer's Disease. Let's dive into the details together. Alzheimer's disease is a neurodegenerative disorder affecting millions of people worldwide. Data suggests that every 3 seconds, one person is diagnosed with AD and its incidence continues to rise. In addition to the typical symptoms of memory loss, AD also involves dysfunction in other organs. However, for a long time, the eye abnormalities in AD patients have been overlooked. The retina and the brain share developmental homology, and the retina is also part of the central nervous system. AD is not just a brain disease, but also an eye disease. In 2024, the Lancet Commission's updated the risk factors for AD to include vision loss among the new factors. Our experimental data further support this, showing that AD mice exhibit visual impairments and pathological changes in retinal structure. We observed the deposition of the AD-related toxic protein A-beta in the retina and optic nerve of AD donors and AD model mice, and further confirmed that A-beta predominantly deposits in the perivascular spaces. Additionally, A-beta deposition was also found in the periorbital lymphatic vessels and the external compartment of the optic nerve. In AD donor and model mice, we used various techniques, including immunofluorescence and a single cell, to analyze proteins related to the A-beta amyloidogenic pathway and did not observe A-beta production by the retina itself. In our study, we confirmed that A-beta in the AD retina is not produced by the retina itself, but is transported from the brain. This process involves three parts: autinergic route, neuronal axon route, and perivascular space route. We will now use a 3D video to provide a detailed explanation.
Brain eye transport allows A-beta from the brain to the retina, encompassing three routes: optic nerve sheath route, neural axon route, and the perivascular space route. Three routes work together to accomplish the transport process. Firstly, A-beta can be transported along the subarachnoid space surrounding the optic nerve. Following that, A-beta can enter the optic nerve and be transported along the neural fibers, accumulating in the axonal compartment. And A-beta inside the axon can pass through lamina cribosa. Thirdly, A-beta can be transported along the parietal spaces of the optic nerve and the retina, ultimately accumulating throughout the entire retina. There is a glymphatic system in the eye. A-beta can influx along the parietal spaces of the retina and exchange with tissue fluid through aquaporin fold alongside blood vessels and then influx through the perinervous spaces. Disrupted polarity or absence of AQP4 results in the slow entry and hinders the retinal self-excretion and the perinervous optic nerve meningeal lymphatic pathway, ultimately accumulating A-beta and exacerbating retinal degeneration.
I would like to express my heartfelt gratitude to the professors for their immense contributions to this work and for their continuous guidance and support throughout the years. Special thanks to Professor Liu Qinghuai from Nanjing Medical University, Professor Xiao Ming from Nanjing Medical University, Professor Huaiqing from Baylor College of Medicine in the United States, Professor Maiken from the University of Rochester, Dr. Xiaowei from the University of Rochester. I would also like to thank the members of the Brain Eye Project team members and all collaborators who have contributed to this project. Thank you all for watching, and feel free to contact me via email if you have any questions.